Hello, everybody, and welcome to Pronunciation Live from BBC Learning English. Thank you so much for joining us. I hope everybody is well today. Please do get in the comments box and introduce yourself and let us know where in the world you are joining us from. This is Pronunciation Live, which is the show where you send in the words that you have difficulty pronouncing and we help you to pronounce them. So also do get in that comments box and let us know any words that you have difficulty with and we will get through as many as we can today. Now, before we begin, please do remember that as this is a pronunciation show, it's important that you can hear the sounds nice and clearly that are being modeled. So if you have a pair of headphones, pop those in, turn those up nice and loud. Or if you don't have a pair of headphones, just turn the volume up and make sure you can hear the sounds clearly. As this is a pronunciation show, I won't be focusing too heavily on word meaning. We will cover meaning a little bit where we have time. But if there are new words for you today, make a note, check them in the dictionary after the show, and you can look up the meaning then. And of course, don't forget, there is a vocabulary show every Monday or every other Monday at 1:30 on Facebook and YouTube on BBC Learning English as well. Now, of course, there are many different accents in English. You will hear some differences maybe in the way that I say things, but I am a native English speaker, so don't worry. I will be modeling them in hopefully a clear way, which has more similarities with other accents than it does differences. So let's take a quick look in the comments box and see who we've got joining us today. We have got Deepanita from India. Hello, nice to see you. Arman from Kazakhstan. Thank you for joining us. We have got Hidayat Rahman from Pakistan, always waiting for the show. I'm glad that you like my accent today. Thank you very much for that. We have got Paul joining us from India. Hello, thank you for joining us. Kasmin, a big hello to you. Hello, Dalbag. Thank you for joining us. We've got Helena from Brazil, a big hello. Hello to Nambatebi and everybody else who is joining us from Uganda, a very big welcome. Asad from Pakistan, a big hello to you. We've got Sueli, thank you for joining us from Brazil. And we have got, is this Moody? Is that your name? Or is that how you're feeling today? Joining us. So a very big welcome to you. And Fano from Madagascar. Hello, Sise from Turkey. Hello, Jason from Indonesia. Hello, Anne. Thank you for joining us. We have got Wachana Pukorn, I hope I said your name correctly, from Thailand, and Lasuda joining us from Kenya. Absolutely fantastic. Thank you for getting in the comments box and introducing yourself, as well as Kozui from Japan. A very, very big welcome. So don't forget, this is the show where you send in the words that you have difficulty pronouncing and we help you to pronounce them. So thank you to everybody who sent in some words before the show. But don't worry if you didn't have time to do that. Get in the comments box, add the words, and I will get through as many as I can. Now, I've had many viewers asking about word stress. So that is built in today's challenge. So before we look at today's challenge, just to make sure everybody understands, let's just take a quick look at what we mean by word stress. So words in English that have one syllable, one sound, don't have any word stress. But if they have two syllables, like photo, or more than two syllables, then one of the syllables will be stressed. That means it is said a bit more strongly than the other syllables. For example, photo. So I hope you can hear that, photo. It's not photo, it's photo. So we've got the stress on the first syllable. Same for photograph, photograph. But listen to this, photography. So here the stress jumps to the ta, photography, photography. Photographic, so now the stress is on the third syllable, photographic, photographical, and photographically. So that's what I mean when I say word stress. Now, today's challenge is, which of these words have the stress on the second syllable? So all of these words are three syllable words. So they have mm-mm-mm. But which of these words have the stress on the second syllable? So please do get in the comments box and let me know which of these words do you think has the stress on the second syllable. So for example, photograph, as we looked at, photograph is a three syllable word, but the stress was on the first syllable. How about these words too? So say the words to yourself, practice them. What do you think? Let's take a look. So Dina thinks this word has the stress on the second syllable. That means the middle syllable. Pratik thinks it is this word. Claudia has chosen A, B, D, and E. What do you think? Do you agree with Claudia? Do you think these words have the stress on the second syllable? Jizzy thinks it is on this word. This student, who I can't read your name, but thinks it is A, B, and E. Del thinks it is B. Alwyn thinks it is E. Pratik also thinks it is this word. Hacker thinks it is A, B, E. Shania thinks A. Jarka thinks C and E. Min thinks A. So get in the comments box, let me know what you think, and I will not just give you the answer at the end of the show, but I will also explain a little bit the rules for where we might have the stress on three syllable words. Okay, so do get in the comments box and let us know any words that you have difficulty pronouncing, and let's see what we've got here. All right, let me go back to the beginning because I saw a good question there. Just a moment. Oops. Okay, so Krishnan, in the phrase, I don't want to put your life on the line, do we drop the T in between the U and the Y? So between... where have we got here? I don't want to put your life on the line. So at the end of put, we don't completely drop the T, but we do soften the T. I don't want to put. I don't want to put. And that's very similar with lots of words that end with T, like that becomes that. What becomes what. And put often becomes put. So yes, this sentence could be said, I don't want to put your life on the line. I don't want to put your life on the line. I hope that helps. Ezra had a similar question. So Ezra sent in a longer question that was asking about what happens to the T in sports center. So Ezra said they have no problem with the word sports and no problem with the word center, but when they put them together, what happens to the T? Again, Ezra, the T doesn't completely disappear, but it does become quite soft. Sports center. And the T and the S sound at the beginning of center kind of join together to make a S center. So if you practice saying center and then add a S, almost a soft T at the beginning, center, center, and then add the sports, you've got sports center, sports center. So Ezra, you might need to take a little bit of time to practice that one. Not super easy, but I hope that helps. Thank you for your question. Amit wanted to know how to pronounce soccer. Soccer. So in Britain, we would actually call the sport football, but the American English word is soccer. And I believe in Australia, they say soccer, which is where you will find the football team, the Socceroos. Socceroos. Okay. Hope that helps, Amit. Jose would like to know how to pronounce internet, internet, internet. And if I say it quickly, Jose, internet, internet, internet. So I hope that helps. Mireille would like to know how to pronounce the word clothes. So we looked at this one last week. We've got a th sound, sorry. So this is where we touch our tongue to our teeth, and then an S sound very quickly after it. So is quite difficult sound to make. You can also just make a Z as kind of Z sound. So clothes, clothes. Many native speakers will just make a Z sound here, clothes. Close. So that might be a little bit easier than trying to get that TH and that S, and it's very common in native English. All right, let's take a look at some of the comments. So Sue, your word is routines, routines, routines. And Sepp would like to know how to pronounce laughter, laughter, laughter. So Sepp, this is where we have an accent difference, because in the south of England, for example, people would say laugh, or some people might say laugh or laughter. In the north of England, where I'm from, we'd say laughter, laughter. So it's an ah sound there. Cindy, your word is suspension. 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 Shh. So it's got a sh sound before the last syllable there. Suspension. Suspension. I hope that helps. Gamaka, your word is distinguish. So dis, ting, guish, a gwa, gwa ish sounds at the end, guish, distinguish, distinguish. Shruti, your word is development, development. So it's quite weak at the beginning there, development. Development with the stress on the second syllable, development. All right, so I want to practice that word stress today. So where are you hearing the stress on the words being modeled today? And Moni Rule, your word is Switzerland, Switzerland. So this is a three syllable word. Where do you hear the word stress? Switzerland, Switzerland, that is on the first syllable. Srinath, your word is admiration, admiration, admiration. Where can you hear the word stress here? So it's a four syllable word, admiration, admiration. Can you hear the stress is on the third syllable, admiration, admiration. I hope that helps. Yuchen, your word is complicated, complicated. Complicated with the stress on the first syllable, complicated. And Chi, your word is personality, personality. Okay. And Namutabe, your word is comparison, comparison. Where is the word stress here? Can you hear comparison? It's on the second syllable, comparison. And anxious. So here the X makes a sh sound, anxious, anxious, with the stress on the first syllable there, anxious, anxious. If you are just joining us, this is Pronunciation Live from BBC Learning English. Please get in the comments box, send in any words that you have difficulty pronouncing, and I will help you to pronounce as many as I can get through today. Don't forget, if you are enjoying the show, please give a hit on the like button. If you are loving the show, then give a hit on the heart button. And of course, remember that you can feel free to share the show with friends, family, students, teachers, anybody who you think might benefit from some pronunciation practice. Biju, who sent in these words before the show, your words are, I'm not going to say the first two because they are from today's challenge. So you will have to come back at the end of the show because we're going to look at where the word stress is. We've also got quirky, quirky, aluminium. Now, this word is said very differently in American English. They say aluminum and they spell it differently. And Biju, I think you spelled it with an American spelling, but I've changed it to a British English spelling. Aluminium, aluminium. And we put the stress on the third syllable, aluminium. You've also sent in the word opaque, opaque, sanctimonious, sanctimonious, and narcissistic, narcissistic. And if you join us at the end of the show, Biju, I will go through the first two words. We will look at the pronunciation and the word stress there. Ming Fong, I saw a post that went out on Saturday, I believe, which was looking at over plus a verb. For example, over ate was one of the example words. We also have overpacked, overcooked. And Ming wanted to know where was the word stress. So the word stress will not be on the over. It will be on the second part of the word. And the word stress will be the same as that word by itself. So for example, if we had overeaten, eaten, the stress is on the E, on the first syllable, and it would be the same when we add over. So overeaten, overpacked. So if we just have over plus one syllable, it will be on the second syllable, the third syllable after over. On more than one syllable, Ming, just keep the word stress the same as if you had the word without over before it. So I hope that helps. Okay, let's take a look here. So Spring sent in the word associated. And Spring said that she heard a kind of shh sound in this word when a native speaker pronounced it. You are right, Spring. There are two ways to pronounce this word. So you could say associated with a sound, associated, or some speakers will turn this into a sh sound, associated. Associated. I think even the same native speaker might sometimes say associated and sometimes say associated. So it doesn't really matter where you're from. It's just a personal choice. So whichever one you prefer, Spring, you can use. Zaro, thank you for your very polite message that you sent in before the show. And you added in the words further, further, and feather. Feather. So we've got an sound in your first word. So if you make that sound and then add further with a sound in the middle there, further. And your second word has an sound, fe, and the same the at the end, feather. So further and feather. I hope that helps. Okay, let's go back to the comments and see some of the fantastic words that you have sent in. 2K Shares would like to know how to pronounce assignment. Assignment. And Mass would like to know how to pronounce espresso. 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 So it's espresso, a word borrowed from another language. Pradeep, your word is diction. Diction. And Modesta, your word is pleasure. So it's got this zh sound in the middle. If you want to practice saying that, zh, pleasure. And it is a pleasure to help you, Modesta. Thank you for sending in that word. Hamishu, your word is a great word. This word is onomatopoeia. Onomatopoeia. So lots of sounds in the middle there. Onomatopoeia. And this means words that sound like their meaning. For example, crack, pop, bang, whiz. They are onomatopoeic words. Adham, your word is considerable. Considerable. And Elena, your word is attendance. 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 Mycola, I hope your words are not speaking about today's lesson. Your words are ridiculous, ridiculous, and incomprehensible. Incomprehensible. So if you couldn't understand something, it would be incomprehensible, but I hope you can understand that. Christopher, these words have the same pronunciation. We've got our and our. But your first word, O-U-R, our, is sometimes pronounced R. Okay, so for example, this is our house. So you could say this is our house or this is our house. It's a very common word, and sometimes we're a little bit lazy to say it. So that's why we have the different pronunciation there. And Deval, your word is consequences. 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 Okay. Let's have a look. We've got DT, your word is failure. 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 Okay. So let's take a look back at today's challenge and see what you think about this. So which of these words have the stress on the second syllable? So these are three syllable words. They are all three syllable words. It's very common in English to have the stress on the first syllable. When you have a three syllable word, it's very common to have the stress on the first syllable. But which of these have the stress on the second syllable? Do you think A, E, G, and H like Amar? Or do you think A, B, C, E like Claudia? Or do you think A, B, H like Rahila? Thanks for joining us again, Rahila. Or do you think A, C, and E like Sueli? Elvin thinks it's C and E. Yin thinks it's A and E. Alexander thinks A. Evgeny thinks B, C, E. Panna thinks A, B, C, E. Oh, we've had Evgeny. Lesdi thinks A. So what do you think? And I will give you the answer, not just the answer, a little bit of an explanation at the end of the show about how we can work out where the word stress might go on three syllable words. Okay, so do get in the comments box and let us know any words that you are having difficulty pronouncing. Sorry, look earlier. Hello from Brazil. Thank you very much for joining us. Let's take a look back at some of the words that were sent in before the show. So Olga, your words are trotter, trotter, batter, minced meat, minced meat. Be very careful if you come to Britain and you buy minced meat. You might be getting very small pieces of meat like beef or pork, but you might also be getting dried fruit that is minced meat without the D. So do be very careful. It's a mistake. They can look very similar. One is fruit, one is meat. So you don't want to make that mistake. The other words you've got here are cuisine, cuisine, consist, consist, specialty, specialty, specialty. And your last word, Olga, is stew, stew. In British English, we have a y sound in the middle here. So stew. So it's got a u sound at the end with a st sound at the beginning. St, stew, stew, stew. Americans often just say stew without this y sound in the middle. So there's a slight difference there. Khalifa, your words are sovereignty, sovereignty, and bureau. Bureau, a difficult word to pronounce here as well, Khalifa. So well done sending that in. Bureau, 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 bureau. I hope that helps. Tangina, your words are anachronistic, anachronistic, and anachronism, anachronism, and anarchy, anarchy. So the CH here is making a K sound, anarchy, and also hallucination, hallucination, hallucination. I hope that helps. And Suja, your words are wanton, wanton, surreal, surreal, sundry, short, and shot. I hope that helps. And Andras, your words are seriously, seriously, ethereal, ethereal, orienteering, experience, and we are becomes we are, and really, really. Now, this word gets sent in a lot. It is a sauce. It's also a place in the UK, and it is Worcestershire. Worcestershire. So there is a town called Worcester, and that is in Worcestershire, which is the county. Worcestershire. Worcestershire. Many learners have difficulty with this word, and many native English speakers who are not from Britain also have difficulty with this word. So hopefully that helps a little bit there. Okay, what have we got here? We've got Abdul Majid would like to know how to pronounce screwdriver. Screwdriver. And Adham, your word is moreover. More over. Moreover. So we've got more and over. You need to add a r sound in the middle. So moreover. 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 Okay, Sam Slim, your words are Korea, Korea, and Korea, a good set of words. The country Korea and your job Korea are very similar. The third word is Korea. Korea. So it's got a k sound at the middle, whereas Korea and Korea, the first two words, have a k sound. Okay, hope that helps. And Lanry, this word is not from English, so it's got a strange pronunciation. It is facade. Facade. It is borrowed from French. Facade. Facade. Hope that helps. Okay, let's take a look at Naing. Your words are injure, injured, injuring, and injury. Okay, I hope that helps. And Evgeny, your words are bone, gauge, licorice. Okay, hope that helps, Evgeny. And we've got Ismail, your word is gadget. 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 And Giao wanted some practice with the kia. Yes, so the k. Y together is cure, and we've got accurate, accurate. So you're right, Gao. It's very difficult. There's lots of sounds going on here. Accurate. So k y together is cure, accurate, and ridiculous, ridiculous, ridiculous. Okay. All right, so let's just take a look at the last of the comments before we have a look at today's challenge and some of the rules for pronouncing three syllable words. Let's have a look here. So we've got Heidi with prefer, jeans, species, nauseous, contagious, and contagion. And this word here is gorgeous. 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 All right. All right. Let's take a look back at today's challenge. Which of these words has the stress on the second syllable? So, as I mentioned, most words that are three syllables will have the stress on the first syllable. Which of these have the stress on the second syllable? I'll give you a little clue by reading them out. So have a listen and see if that changes your answer. So Claudia thinks A, B, C, and E. Does it change when I read these words out? So we've got statistic, embellish, traumatic, estimate, contentious, complicate, sanctuary. And century. All right, I'll read those again. What do you think? Where do we have the stress on the second syllable? Statistic, embellish, traumatic, estimate, contentious, complicate, sanctuary, and century. Okay, Evgeny, did you change your answer after you heard the words? You've put B, C, and E. Cindy thinks A, B, E. Mikola thinks A, B, C, and E. Let's take a look. Mikola Nicola, you are absolutely correct. It is A, B, C, and E. So very well done if you said that. Also to Sam, who gave the same answer. Alexander, who also got A, B, E. We've got C in there as well, but very well done to you, Alexander. Excellent work. Almost done. Close, not too far off. And you got three of them, Alendi. So well done. Let's just take a look. So statistic, embellish, traumatic, and contentious have the stress on the second syllable. The other words have the stress on the first syllable. But what is the rule? Let's take a quick look. Most three-syllable words will have the word stress on the first syllable. But if the word is followed by a suffix, which is a little extra bit on the end, that is ish, ic, or ious, then the stress will be on the syllable before the suffix. And this doesn't matter if it's a three-syllable word or a four-syllable word or a five-syllable word. We would usually put the stress before the last syllable, the syllable with this suffix, like in these examples. There are more suffixes that follow this rule. So if you go to Facebook or YouTube after the show and look up the show, I will add a link to Tim's pronunciation workshop where you can see some more examples where the word stress comes before the last syllable. I hope that helps. I hope that's given you a little bit of practice. Try to think of some other words ending with these suffixes, like Ezra, fantastic, who's got delicious. Fantastic, Ezra. Perfect example. We've got the stress on the second syllable before the last syllable. Reddish, yes. So again, it's on the syllable before the last one. Establish, selfish. It doesn't matter how many syllables, the stress will be on the one before that. So thank you very much, Ambitious, as well, for sending in all these fantastic examples. I hope that has helped. If you've enjoyed the show, please don't forget to hit that like button. Or if you love the show, then hit that heart button. Don't forget, we are here every Tuesday and every Thursday at 1:30 on Facebook and YouTube. So thank you so much for joining us. Thanks for your hard work today. And I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye bye.